okay, I prepared this presentation in English, and I will be really quick. I won't unfold the whole article. Please read it. You can find it on the magazine. I just tell you two stories. We can call them my tales. Yeah? So these stories triggered me to write this article. And okay, let's start with the first one. This is an exercise. You can read it. Very simple, no tricks here. The solution is what you think is the solution. This was for my daughter. I think she was 8 years old or something like that when she got this exercise. And she had no idea how to solve it. And I told him, let's try an error. We heard about try an error. Let's imagine that one of the numbers is one. And let's see what happened. And she was shocked. She was not willing to try, because they did not learn that on the school, and they were not allowed to use any method to solve a problem that was, let's say, not approved by her teacher. So, not that the solution was important, but the method, how they arrived at the solution. And she has 10 more years on the school. And after she finishes the school, she will be trained, she will be dressed that there are right methods to solve a problem and are wrong methods to solve a problem. And don't confuse these two. And just imagine that we did the same thing. We are through in this process as well. And the second story, it's a bit more complicated. This was in a factory where cooler fans for cars are produced. And this is the production line. And there are two molding machines. One of them produces the blades, the other one produces the case. And the conveyor belts transport to the pieces to workers, and they assemble the fan. It's quite simple, but the machines produce one piece in every, let's say, 1 minute. They have a fixed frequency. And the workers, they are humans. They do not have a fixed frequency. They have needs. One of them are slower, others are faster. There can appear problems during the assembly process. So it quite frequently happens that some pieces accumulate on the conveyor belt, and in order to avoid the damage, that they can fall down from there, and to avoid that, so they have to go there, took the pieces and store somewhere. They call this accumulating a buffer and then consuming the buffer when the molding machine stops for some reason. Then they can use these pieces to continue working. Okay, now this is a situation. This was a situation actually. It was present in the factory. And the question is whether is this a problem or not. And some leaders can say that this is not a problem because actually it is solved. So there is no damage, every piece is, let's say, safe. So there is no problem here. But the CEO of this certain factory considered that this is a problem because this consuming, accumulating the buffer and consuming the buffer is an action that has no added value. And it's not corresponding with the principle of lean production. So in his perception, this is a problem. And what I want to say here, that the problem is a matter of perception. There is no situation that which is labeled that I am a problem, we have to solve it. We have to discover these problems. And let's connect with the first story. We have to discover that routine solutions or solutions that work may not be the best one. And that's why I put this question that who needs innovation. So everybody needs the innovation, who has the motivation, has the trigger, has the drive, and has the initiative to do something better. Thank you.